What is up, people? Today we're going to be talking about the DJI Mavic Mini drone weighing in at just 249 grams. Its features, what's in the box, and if it's worth buying. So if you want to know how you can increase the quality of your YouTube channel, your vlogs, or your videos, continue watching. I'm going to show you a couple of shots that I've already taken with this drone, alongside some color grading that I've already performed on them, just so you can get an idea of what the footage is like before you continue to watch and see if it's worth buying for you. Anyway, onto the video. I bought the $459.99 version. With that, you get this case, which is really handy, and you get three batteries. So each battery holds up to half an hour of power. Inside the case, I keep a bunch of extra, like, wings. A wing. More extra wings. Oh, more extra wings. So yeah, if you're gonna crash a plane, you don't have a drone, and you never used one, it's probably a good idea to get this one. Because you also get the greatest thing ever, I suppose, if you're a little bit nervous. So they're just like guards. Can you see those? Good for if you're gonna try flying it into a tree. Don't do that. So yeah, you get two of those. So if you crash it and screw that one up, you get another one. So there's a lot to prepare yourself for if you go wrong. You've got a lot of gear to replace it. This is a controller that you get. Pretty simple. It's got a cable for a micro USB, which you kind of get like on a Samsung. This one, which is like, they tend to use on like a Huawei. Basically all types of phones, and then you get an Apple one, okay? The one annoying thing about this is that you can't use a case. So I just take the case off because it just doesn't fit, but it is what it is, right? It is what it is. Guys, our governments might be tackling the drone problem, but look at this power move. Releasing a drone 1 gram underneath the limit. So you do not need a license to fly this drone in the UK, I believe in the USA. Obviously for any other areas, you do need to check, but in most places it is 250 grams. You don't need a license. You can fly this anywhere. Absolutely perfect for traveling. If you know, if you're gonna do travel vlogs, you don't need to apply for registration in multiple countries. So you can fly that in the UK as long as you don't have any accessories on it. As soon as you put an accessory on it, it's over 249 grams. So you'll need to register for a license, which is £9. Pretty easy. Yeah, I just did the test. Like, I woke up and just did the test. You don't have to revise for it, to be fair. Like, it's super simple. The one thing to note, I forgot to buy a micro SD card. Get yourself one of those. I bought the 64GB, this one. It's the SanDisk Extreme Micro SD XC. It's more than enough, bro. Like, I've had no problems with it. It records fine. There's no stopping, no pausing. So when you want to get this started, all you have to do is press that, hold it down, it's activated. Then the remote, once you've got that charged up as well, like, I for some reason, I didn't think that you needed to charge this. You do. Okay, so you just use the cable that you get to charge the batteries, and you just plop that in there and leave that to charge. For some reason, I thought it had power off the phone. That made sense to me, but yeah, no. I'm gonna fly the drone to here, and you can get a good view of it then, as close as you're gonna get to it flying, I suppose. You've kind of got an idea of what it looks like when you're controlling it through the phone. The drone, to be fair, is really easy to fly, in my opinion. Like, even in like wind, when it's come up with a wind warning on here, I've had absolutely no problems at all. It's been absolutely brilliant. You can send it up in the sky up to 500 meters. Obviously, you need to check your regulations in your country. You need to check that, and the max distance as well is about 4 kilometers, which is 2.5 miles. That's wild for a drone of that size and at that price point. And it shoots, most importantly, it shoots in 2.7k. okay, so if you go to video, as you can see here, you can go to 1080p and then you can shoot between 25 and 60 FPS, so you can get kind of a more like slow-mo effect with that. The 2.7K is only 25 or 30 FPS. Still, the quality is very good. You have three flight modes, you got Cine Smooth, which is like really good for those smooth, like cinematic shots. If you're gonna like send it up and glide over something like in a city, it'd be amazing. Really, really like smooth. Obviously, you've got the gimbal on the camera, so it's not gonna be shaking around or anything like that. And then you have the position mode, which I think is just kind of like a standard mode. I don't really use that one. I tend to use a sport mode. With that, you just get like a higher speed. I believe the drone goes up to 30 miles per hour. Something to take note of with the drone, to have kind of control over exposure. If you go to the camera in the settings and you go down to advanced settings, what you want to do is turn on the histogram. That will pop up your histogram on the screen there, which you can see, okay? And what I use is the overexposure warning. Just if you're not like amazing at reading like the histogram, I found the overexposure warning is quite good. It just brings up a black and white strip on your camera where you can see it's overexposed. There's all the main points that I have about the camera and what you want to change in the settings to get a professional film look. All right, what else is in here? That had the plug-in, manual, batteries. Okay, so that's everything. I'm now gonna take the drone out and we're gonna have a look at how it performs, and you'll be able to see the footage that I capture. I'll edit it, color grade it, and then we'll go from there, and you can see how this drone could improve your footage overnight. Absolutely, a 10 out of 10, a worthwhile investment from me, okay? Let me know your thoughts down below about this.